Welcome to this week's White House History Weekly. Just last week, the White House Historical Association released our latest publication, Wine and the White House, A History. The author is the chairman of the board of directors of the White House Historical Association, Fred Ryan, and today he's going to tell us about the history of storing wine at the White House. You know, there's the great story of Queen Elizabeth and Buckingham Palace, and I believe they can store about 38,000 bottles of wine in their wine cellar. That's not quite the case at the White House. Fred, take us into the wine cellar at the White House and tell us its history.
Well, the storage of wine and the White House wine cellar has evolved over time. When John Adams moved into the White House and then Thomas Jefferson succeeded him, the White House, even during Jefferson's time, was not complete. There was a lot of work remaining to be done. And one of the things that Jefferson pointed out was that there was no wine cellar. So Jefferson designed the first White House wine cellar, and it's a design similar to one that he used in Monticello. Interestingly, in the War of 1812, when in August of 1814, the British burned the White House, as you know, the famous story of Dolly Madison saving the painting of George Washington. And I wondered, what happened to the wine? I did some research and found after the White House was burned, it wasn't the British, but American soldiers came to the White House and drank all the wine that remained in the White House wine cellar. And when the White House was rebuilt, there was another wine cellar, a sizable wine cellar, that served presidents for many years until, as you know, the major renovation took place in the White House during the Truman administration, 1948 to 52. And that seems to be the time the White House wine cellar, for all intents and purposes, went away. And I can just tell you from personal experience, when I worked in the Reagan White House, having interest in wine, I kept asking the curator to show me the wine cellar. And I guess I asked him enough, and he finally capitulated during one of the August times when President Reagan was away at the ranch. He said, come on, I'm going to show you the wine cellar. And he took me in there, and it's a very little room. It's not a wine cellar. It's a room that's very small, essentially a pantry off of the kitchen. Today, if you think about it, earlier presidents would purchase wine, sometimes in large quantities, and they would stockpile them for their own use, and in some cases for the use of future presidents. Well, the way wine services evolved today, this modest closet holds enough because the White House doesn't need more than a few hundred bottles at the most, because the wine is purchased individually for events. So a few weeks in advance of a major state dinner, they'll purchase the wines, they'll have them in the wine cellar to rest, and they're able to serve them from there.